They're a three-piece band, electro-pop band made up of Jordan Whitaker and Cameron Wright of the Ready Set and Jess Bowen of the Summer Set. Their debut EP out now called Communication on off of Razor and Tie. Check them out this Saturday at the Sold Out Show with the Spill Canvas. And you can find out music, tour dates, and more at facebook.com/NEKOKAT official. Let me bring Jess, Jordan, and Cameron all on. Guys, thank you guys so much for being a part of the show. How's everything going?
Great.
Hey.
I'm doing fantastic. I'm happy to have you guys here. Jordan, we've been longtime friends. Cameron, we've been longtime friends. And Jess, we've been longtime friends too, but you haven't really been on the show a lot. But welcome back to the show, guys, and I'm happy to have you guys here.
Thank you for having us.
So what's going on? Just new EPs out now. What is the plan for tour? What is the plan? I mean, obviously, Jess, of course, the new Somerset record's coming out. Cam and Jordan, you're working on this project and also maybe some new Ready Set stuff as well. But what is the plan? What is the plan for tour and everything else besides this sold-out show on Saturday?
I think we're kind of just figuring out. Like, it's kind of interesting because we've only been a band for, like, I guess officially maybe like a month and a half or 2 months now. So it still is super new. So we're just trying to get a little bit more music out, just play a few shows around LA and maybe New York, and then try to figure out a touring thing after that. But I definitely want to get out on the road with it. It's been all that, at least me personally, it's been like my focus for a good majority of this year. So, you know, whenever the right opportunity comes along, I think we're probably all about it, you know.
Definitely. And Jordan there, you got to perform at Warped Tour in Pomona. How was that experience for you? I mean, being to do it acoustically with our good friend and your good friend, Mike Naren.
Oh, yes, Mike Naren. Mike's the best, so it was really fun.
Yeah, he's actually Mike. In Vegas. He's actually in Vegas hanging out right now, not with me, but hopefully soon. Hanging out, grabbing a beer, having a good time. And I wish you guys were here. I mean, you guys all got to hang out at the APMA. How was that experience for you guys to be at you guys all been there before. So how was the experience there to get out and be on a Nick Major's simulcast on Periscope there? While everybody knows you guys were on Periscope, if everybody was hanging out on Periscope, how was that experience for you guys?
I just think it was awesome to go and, you know, just be NEKOKAT and just hang out with, you know, our friends that we knew from Warped, and it was just really a fun time. It was just a fun thing for us to do.
It was kind of like our first also like appearance out as NEKOKAT together, so
right.
it was a cool experience for all of us, so.
Yeah, and Cameron, I love your blonde hair. Gotta say that.
Thank you.
Gotta say, you with blonde hair works. I mean, I've known this kid for a while, so I can say compliments like that because he's a cool dude and he knows music and knows what he's doing. And the styling of the blonde hair and NEKOKAT is great. And Jess, big ups to you. I mean, honestly, I support everything you do and everything you would do as a person. You're a great person and standing up for your rights as a human being. And as a drummer, as an artist, as a part of the LGBT community that you are, great stuff. Continue success with that, and keep on getting the word out and telling people to stand up for themselves.
Oh, thank you. I really appreciate that. Thanks for the kind words.
You're smiling over there. I can say that. Go ahead. Go ahead, Jess.
I'm blushing like a little half-Jordan.
That's awesome. I that was not one of the things I planned to do, but that's great. And for everybody out there listening, I know everybody's like retweeting that you're live on the show and all that. So everybody out there listening, if you guys want to talk to these guys and gal, please do 347-826-7096. And let's talk about the music. How did this project come together? I mean, I know you guys are all good friends in the music scene and all that, but what made you guys choose each other to be like, hey, you know what, this project would be crazy to do and awesome to see what happens with it?
Well, me and Cameron had been like touring with Ready Set stuff a couple years ago. He played bass with me, and then known Jess since like 2010 or something, and we've done a couple tours together with the Ready Set and Somerset. So pretty much me and Cameron started writing some songs just for fun, just to kind of like see what it would be like to do a little bit more like rocky type stuff, more like guitar based, and kind of went from this little side thing just to being like, we should actually make this a band and see kind of how it goes. And we were like, well, we need a drummer. So Cameron was at a bar one night and saw our friend Jess at said bar, and then was like, hey, you should ask Jess to play drums with us. So I texted her, and she obliged. And then that's pretty much our whole story there. It's not too exciting.
He's lying. We found each other on Match.com.
Yeah.
Bandmatesmeet.com. It's not blackpeoplemeet.com. It's bandpeoplemeet.com, and that's how it happened.
Yeah, exactly.
you know what's funny though? Like today's like every commercial I've seen on TV late at night, like watching Comedy Central or any of the shows, it's like blackpeoplemeet.com. I'm like, why do we need that? Why do we need an actual like or farmersonly.com?
Farmers,
it's like,
yeah.
Why do we need these? Why can't we have a page called bandpeoplemeet.com where if you need a bassist, here's a bassist in your you know 5 mile radius. You know that would be crazy. So I'm gonna do that right now. So
I was gonna say,
let's
that's
do
a new venture for you.
So here's the deal. Everybody out there, Cam, Jess, and Jordan, we're all gonna do that right now. That's our new venture, bandpeoplemeet.com. Boom, sold, licensed. Nobody else can have it. Right here, it's
patent.
Our venture.
We're gonna patent that.
Yeah, and we're going to LLC it. We're going to make millions off of it. So, Cameron, you want to say something? Go ahead.
I feel like there should be some sort of dating platform for dogs. You know, it's hard. I feel like it's hard for a dog to get out there and meet other dogs of the opposite sex because they're just on leashes all the time. And it's like my dog is surfing the web pretty much constantly. And he hasn't had much luck with the ladies, so.
Hey, why not call up the resident the artist known as Doug the Pug? Why not call up Doug the Pug? Maybe Doug the Pug can hook you up some ladies, you know, lady dogs.
I love Doug the Pug. There you go.
There you go. Maybe Doug the Pug or any of the famous pets out there. Maybe Grumpy Cat or Grumpy Dog for that matter. I don't know. If you heard of Grumpy the Dog yet, but he's really grumpy as well. Or is it Happy Pup? I don't know which one it is. Is it Happy Pup or Crazy? Yeah, I don't know which one it is, but it's one of the two. Well, let's get to the music. You have the new single out called Give Me the Break. What is that song about there, Jordan, Jess, and Cameron? Who wrote it? Where did it come from? And what is it about?
We wrote it, and it is about kind of like the idea of somebody who's having like kind of a hard time figuring out their identity and just kind of clinging on to every possible thing that's there. Like anything that comes their way, they kind of just like turn into this type of person that's clearly not who they are. And it's kind of just about how like no matter what stage I feel like you're at in your life, there's always going to be people like that who really are just kind of like doing this in like this really weird sort of obnoxious way. It's just kind of about like telling that type of person just to sort of relax and just kind of do their thing and stop thinking so much about, like, what everyone else thinks about you. At least that's what it means to me. I don't know if that's the same for Jess and Cameron, but that's my take on it.
I think that's pretty on point, yeah.
Thanks, Cameron.
Yeah.
Of course.
So,
I'm in my bed right now. I'm wearing no pants.
That was a question from everybody out there that's looking to date Cameron, I guess. I don't know. I haven't gotten any questions like that on Twitter yet. But all the Twitter-holics, if you guys are out there, listen again, because honestly, you're all you're 21-plus people favorited the link that you posted, Jordan, or one of the guys in Cameron or Jess, maybe whoever does the NEKOKAT Twitter. 21-plus people favored it. So if you're listening in or retweeted it, for that matter, where's your questions, guys? I would like to hear some questions for the people out there. But while we do that, while we wait for the questions out there, let's get to the song right now. I'm going to bring it up here. And Cam, go ahead and introduce it.
This song's called Give Me a Break by our band NEKOKAT.
And it's going to take me a second to get it up here. Damn it, the damn internet's going slow. It's the heat wave out here in Vegas. Maybe NEKOKAT needs to come to Vegas soon. I mean, honestly, it would be great for the fans out here that didn't get a Warped Tour date, for that matter. But here it is, Give Me a Break by NEKOKAT, and we'll be right back after this. And right there, ladies and gentlemen, NEKOKAT with Give Me a Break. And we are back with Jess, Jordan, and Cameron. And also, guys, we got a call from a special friend of everybody's. I think we mentioned him earlier. And I think he's awesome. And he's hanging out in Vegas with the whole BVB Juliet Sims camp. So let's bring the one, the only Mike Naren on right now. Mike, you're on the air with your friends.
What? Oh, yes. What a surprise. Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Mike.
He tweeted me, and he was like, you should call in right now, and NEKOKAT's on there. And I was like, oh, I got to do it. I got to say what's up to my friend here.
Michael, this is amazing.
Yeah, what's up, guys?
Not
good.
What are you doing?
What's up with you?
I'm just hanging out. We have, like, 2 days off in Vegas. I was actually about to text Jordan and say that you guys should just come out here since you're only, like, 4 hours away and hang out with me.
Dude, I wish we were doing that.
Yeah. I'm here for two days. What's up, guys?
See, Mike, real quick, we got, before we went to break, Cam said that he's in his bedroom without pants on, so he's not coming to Vegas right now. So that's until he puts some pants on. Until he puts some pants on, you can't come to Vegas.
I mean, I could come to Vegas, but I'll be wearing no pants.
Yeah. I'm all about the no pants show up, Cam.
Dude, Mike, you know what I was actually doing the other night?
What's that?
I was wearing pants while I was doing this. I was watching videos of you on YouTube, and I was putting, you know how on YouTube you can put videos on slow motion?
Yeah.
So I was watching videos of you in slow motion.
Yes, it's awesome. Dude,
it
amazing.
Was pretty great. Yeah,
I love
you
it.
You are extremely entertaining in slow motion.
Oh,
you're not
well,
entertaining
man,
in regular speed. You're just an entertaining guy all around. You're a great guy.
I'm glad you just had a great Sunday night off of that. That's amazing to me.
Thank you.
And he's also going to be taking a picture with Old Man Cupid down on Fremont. Is that correct there, Mike? We would like to see that on your Facebook and Twitter.
Wait, what did you want to see? I'm sorry, you cut out.
We would like to see you take a picture of Old Man Cupid and yourself in Vegas.
Yeah.
On Fremont.
Yeah. I'll try to find that, man. Definitely. I'm into it. Yeah.
Dude, Cam, you know what I'm talking about. Go ahead. Yeah. Go ahead, Mike.
I just wanted to call in and say what's up to you guys. Hell yeah. I miss you all.
Miss you, Mike.
Yeah. Hey, well, I'll be back sooner than you think. I gotta hang out.
Okay.
Well, there you go, Mike. Well, thanks, Mike, calling in. I'll talk to you soon, all right?
Hell yeah. I'll see you guys later. Bye.
Bye, Mike.
All right. That was entertaining for the past 5 minutes. That brought the ratings up. We got a question, though, from the a girl that's a big fan of the Ready Set and also NEKOKAT, and also I believe that she may be a big fan of Black Veil Brides. I'm not sure. Barb's Parker wants to know, are you ever going to be, when can we expect a full-length album?
I don't know. I think we just want to put out, like, a ton of songs, like, in maybe just different ways before we really do, like, a full album. Like, I think, like, if I had it my way, if I could just choose the perfect scenario, I'd want to have, like, just new stuff come out every couple weeks, just, like, put out songs and, like, videos all the time, and not really think so much about, like, a album or anything like that. Just, like, as long as there's new stuff coming out, I think I'll be pretty stoked, I think. I don't know if that's the same for everybody, but,
yeah.
I don't know.
I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're on the same page.
We do have, like, 30-plus songs demoed, but...
Yeah,
wow.
Yeah.
That would be interesting. I mean, I would like that. I like that idea though too. But I don't think, you know, I'm not criticizing anything, but I think the labels that you may join or be put on, I don't think they would have the marketability to do that right away or want to do that. They want to do it, you know, you got to have an EP or a full length to put out. But maybe if you guys did it independently and said, "Hey, you know what? We're going to do it this way." And Jordan, you already have a fan base. Jess, you do too, and Cam, you do too. So it's kind of like, why not utilize your fan bases and say, "Hey, here's a new song. Here's a new song in the next 3 weeks or so," and put it out. Like, it would be great. Honestly, you know, it would be awesome that if the music scene could be like that, because honestly, everything, like, we know as musician fans and also, you know, just regular people, the music scene nowadays is all built about singles. And that hit song, like, hey, Love Like Woe did a lot, and also Jess, your stuff did a lot with the Somerset. On certain levels, you guys were Macy's band, and all this other stuff, and iHeartRadio, and just put out a single. And I think Give Me a Break is one of them. I mean, Give Me a Break is saying, hey, you know what, the music scene needs to give me a break and say, hey, you know what, the single is great. Why not? Why? Who cares about a full length album anymore? No one has the span to listen to a full length album anymore, if I'm correct.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so I mean I think for us, like, we just want to be putting stuff out as often as we can and just keep doing our thing.
Well, let's do this. Jess, go ahead and introduce the title track of the EP. We'll get to it, and if any of the fans that are listening in, because I know Barb, you're listening in, why not call in 347-826-7096. We'll get you guys on, get to talk to Jess, Jordan, and Cameron, and everything like that. But go ahead. Oh, actually, wait. We have a phone call. As I said, the number, they called in. So let's get to the phone call. 832 area code. Who's this? Where are you calling in from?
The phone call. Hi. My name is Kelsey. I'm
Kelsey, what's going on? Do you have a question for the guys and gal?
Yeah.
Go for it.
I kind of tuned in, so I don't know if, like, someone who's already... Oh, I can't
turn down your computer real quick.
Either at the same time.
turn it down. Turn it down real quick. Turn off your computer.
Okay, sorry. I was getting too excited.
It's all right, Kelsey. It's all right. Go ahead. Shoot.
I decided to, like, tune in, so I don't know if, like, someone's already asked this question or not. But, is the Ready Set, like, is Jordan taking, like, a break from it? Or like, are you going to be working on with both collaborations? Or, I don't know. I'm just curious.
I'm not taking a break from it. I'm just, like, I'm working on, actually, some new stuff with it. Currently, I have, like, a bunch of new songs kind of ready to go, but I was kind of, like, going back and forth between the two, between NEKOKAT and that.
Yeah,
but,
I really like NEKOKAT. It's, like, I've been playing it a lot in my car.
Thank you. That's awesome.
Thanks. Yeah, like, cool. It sounds like there's so many, like, it could be on the radio. I'm like, why isn't it on the radio? Like, do y'all have a label yet, or... No, I don't know. I'm so awkward. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
It's adorable. It's adorable, though. Awkwardness is adorable. Go ahead, Cam or Jordan. Go, ever. Go, go.
Yeah.
EP came out on a label, on the same label that Jordan does the Ready Set stuff on.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. That's cool. Yep. And so, like, you should get it, like, on the radio. I don't know. I mean, I'm sure you want it on the radio. Yeah.
That's weird.
I mean, you're actually, like, on the radio right now, aren't you?
Yeah.
I'm so, like...
Kelsey, do you follow New Music Inferno yet? If you don't, you should. You should be
no,
a fan of the show.
Are they on here, too? I'm so sorry for neglecting you. I can't
forget. Yeah, that is me. That I'm the host of New Music Inferno.
Oh, okay. You're the host, and it's like a band?
No, it's not a band. It's a podcast. It's the podcast. That's what it's called, New Music Inferno.
Oh, okay.
Well, Kelsey, thank you for calling in. And also, you should tune in next Monday because we have the one, the only Mike Shea from Alternative Press being on the show
okay,
as well.
Okay, cool. Yeah, sorry. I'm so awkward. I just wanted to say hi and say I love y'all and stuff. Okay.
Thank
all
you
right.
so much,
bye.
Kelsey.
Thanks for calling in.
I love it. I don't care. Awkwardness is fun and cute. It's cute all the time because it's like, you know, they're a fan of the music, but they also don't know how to conduct themselves, but it's cute. It's not bad to say it's cute because awkwardness is fun. And on the radio when she's having fun. Yes, it's fun and it's cool, Jess. And we want you to introduce Communication right now. We want to get to the music right now of the band NEKOKAT and play the titles track right now. So, Jess, go ahead and swing at it, and let's get to the music.
All right. Well, this is the title track off of our EP called Communication.
All right.
Detained in me, but see it how you choose to see. No, we'll leave it at that. In a town where the sun plays on and on, stare until it blinds my eyes. Say it if it's on. Is it funny? Is it cruel to feel okay without you? Sanity. And the way you slam the door. You know I love you, but only once you've gone, gone. I find you here, here and then. They communicate to me. I've been shape-shifting. Can't wait for you to see. In a town where the sun plays on and on and on. Stare until it burns my eyes. Say it if it's on your mind. Is it funny? Is it cruel? To feel okay without you.
And right there is, ladies and gentlemen, is communication by NEKOKAT. We are back with Jordan, Jess, and Cameron of the band. And while we were on song break, I got an email from the newspaper here about entertainment piece about the new movie that's coming out that's been announced, the Pez movie. So I believe that Give Me a Break should be in the Pez movie coming out here whenever it does.
That sounds like a great idea. I used to love Pez, so yeah, I would totally be okay with that.
Well, here's the deal then. Pez, if you're listening in, we should sponsor the next NEKOKAT tour. So, the NEKOKAT World Tour presented by Pez and New Music Inferno. How about that?
I'm all about it.
Yep. I'm on board.
I love that.
So yeah, we got main people. Down. What? Go ahead. Go ahead, Cam.
I think it'd be rad if you made little Pez dispensers of your head.
Well, you know what? If I could have somebody do that, that would be awesome. And also, if we could make Cameron's head and also Jordan and Jess's heads in Pez as well. So we came up with four good ideas. Badpeoplemeet.com, dogmeet.com, Give Me a Break in, well, five good ideas. Give Me a Break in the Pez movie, the Pez-sponsored New Music, and Pez and New Music Inferno sponsored NEKOKAT World Tour, and also Pez dispensers of all of our heads.
And then we can all eat out of each other.
Oh my god, that's just horrible. The way you put it. Oh, this is great. Well, I know we're running out of time. You guys have, you're in Arizona, guys, Jordan and Jess, because that's what Mike said. You guys are 4 hours away. Or you're in LA, who knows, wherever you may be. But also, Cam, you have to put pants on and get something to eat because you just woke up. And you guys may have a writing session, whatever you guys are doing today. That's great. It's Monday. Maybe even, hey, why not this? Why not you guys just travel down the old highway and get to San Diego on Wednesday, hang out with Mike and Juliet and the rest of the gangs there in Warped Tour land for one day in San Diego. Is that going to happen? Maybe not. Who knows? Maybe they're the special guests in San Diego, because Waka Flocka Flame was the special guest in Salt Lake. So who knows? But before we go here, right, guys, everybody go ahead and tell everybody where they can find you guys on the Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, where they can find NEKOKAT, where they can pick up the EP, physical, non-physical copies, and anything else you want to say to the fans out there real quick as well.
Our Twitter and our Instagram is We Are NEKOKAT, and the Facebook is NEKOKAT Official, and our website is wearenekokat.com. You can get all of our songs off of iTunes, Spotify, and all that stuff. And yeah, we love you. Thanks for checking us out.
Jess, anything you want to say?
Just that, you know, thanks for supporting us, and, you know, that's that's about it. That's all I've got to say. I love the fans. They're the best.
Cameron, any last words?
Any last words? Like, I'm about to walk the plank. No, thanks a lot for having us on the show, and thanks to everyone listening, and we love you, we love the show, and we love all the fans, you know, that listen to
us. Well, Jess,
thank you.
Jess, Jordan, and Cameron, thank you guys so much for being a part of the show. I wish I had t-shirts to send you guys personally, but, you know, I don't have the money to send you guys all t-shirts, but maybe one day we'll, once New Music Inferno gets up there higher and closer to baller status, if you want to say that, or boss. Let's just change it to boss status, because I want to be a boss in the music industry. But guys, thank you so much, and hopefully, you know, you guys can check out the Mike Shea interview next week. I will mention you guys to Mike and say what's up to him from you guys as well next week when we have him on next Monday. So guys, thank you so much. Thank you, Jordan. Thank you, Jess. Thank you, Cameron. Have a great day, guys. Enjoy your sunny days. Go grab a drink. Relax. It's almost 5 o'clock. On the West Coast here, so grab a drink, grab an umbrella, grab some beach pillows or towels, and go enjoy the beach weather. So, guys, thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Bye. Love you guys. And everybody, that was Jess, Jordan, and Cameron of the band NEKOKAT, and the Ready Set, and the Summer Set, and just awesomeness that they are. Thank you for being part of the show. Guys, we'll be back next week, as of right now, Monday.